I'm Richard Lewis, reporting for CadRed.org. I'm here with the inevitable winners of our tournament here, the AMD Sapphire CSGO Invitational. It was, of course, Nip, and this guy, he doesn't do interviews very often. It is Forrest. Thank you for doing an interview.
No
first
problem,
of all,
man. No problem.
Okay, where do we begin? Right now, everyone's saying you're on another level. You're completely untouchable. Is it because you guys have just got the ultimate kind of support and setup compared to the other teams that are chasing you? Is it about having that salary, being able to put the hours in?
I don't think it's about salary or anything. I think we're a team with good chemistry right now. We got in two source players. We are 1.6 players. It gave us a good edge in the game in the beginning. And it works out really good for us. And we put in a lot of hours working on team play and trying to understand. We're really focusing on how other teams play during the game. So we don't really watch that much demos early, but we try to,
React
to what they're doing during the game, yeah? So that's how we play at the moment, and so far it works out. I don't know if other teams, I don't know what they're missing really, but it's hard to tell, but whatever we're doing, it's working.
Can you tell us how much the source players actually contribute? Because you know what it's like, there's certain websites out there and they say that it's 1.6 versus source when you play very games, and it's the fact that you and GetRight and Zizd are so amazing that you carry the source players through. Can you tell us about what they actually bring to the team in your opinion?
They bring what everyone else is bringing, really. I think we all have different position in the game, different kind of roles, and everyone is contributing the way they should. You're always going to have the one guy with the most amount of kills, but that's his role, right? The other guy's we gotta help each other out, and whoever gets the most kills, fine. We don't care really, as long as we win the game. But they contributed a lot in the beginning, getting us comfortable with the source engine and really how the game should be played and how the smoke flashes work. So they contribute a lot.
I flew over, sat in front of GetRight and Freiburg on the plane, and they were telling me that, Freiburg wasn't telling me this, he was denying it, but apparently Freiburg's really starstruck whenever he talks to you, and he completely idolizes and worships you. A, is this true, and B, is that weird?
Well, there is rumors that whenever I change a setting or do something, he tends to actually do the same thing without telling us until we caught him actually doing it, you know?
Wow.
I don't think it's weird.
It's just
quite funny, really.
It's nice to have fans. I remember when I used to have fans. Let's talk about, what's going to be happening next with Nip, because, you know, you guys have got, I'm pretty sure you've got the means to go to any event. I'm sure you've got, a reputation to maintain. So what are you going to be doing?
Next up, we're going to play Thor Open in Sweden. I don't know the teams really, but it's going to be tough. We're obviously the most studied team at the moment. Everyone want to beat us, but want to be the first team to beat us. So we have a lot of work to do. We got go straight back home, need to figure out what to do next, and just practice. And then we're going to NorthCon, so it's going to be a hectic schedule right now. But hopefully we can pull it through.
I want to ask you a few personal questions. Not that personal, don't worry. But for me, and I think a lot of people, you are the greatest kind of 1.6 player that played the game. When CSGO presented itself, you were actually really keen to move over. Certainly one of the more keen players to do that. Was it hard to leave 1.6 behind? And was it weird to transition to a new game? Or by that point, did you want to play something new?
Actually, when I first got the beta in New York, me and GetRight were kind of surprised. It wasn't the best game at the moment. It had a lot of flaws, a lot of changes had to be done. But somehow, I think we both felt that it's time for a new game, at least for me, right? I've been playing for 10 plus years now, 1.6 all the way. And at some point, I felt done. Like, I achieved pretty much everything I wanted to achieve in 1.6. I'm very grateful to the community who supported the game throughout, but I felt done. Yeah. And it was fun to have CSGO come into the scene, and I was really excited, and Valve did a great job with the updates to keep listening. I know people out there don't think they're listening, but you can't satisfy thousands of different people, right? You need to find some balance, and they're doing a great job, in my opinion at least.
Are you welcoming that the fact that there's new kind of, well, not new, but rather more 1.6s moving over to CSGO, like some old school names we've seen Na'Vi come across? Is that something you think is going to really help the game take off?
Yeah, for sure, but it's going to be a tough time for them, right?
Well, what advice would you have for them? You've done it. How did you do it?
It's open-minded. You need to be open-minded. You can't have, like, if you tap with the AK, say, and you think, like, okay, it's not like 1.6, and you get angry because the recoil is different. You need to be open-minded and see the game as a new game. You can't keep comparing the game to 1.6 or whatever game you play. You always have to have an open mind and just play and enjoy. If you don't enjoy it, quit, because there's no point forcing yourself.
And last question before I let you go to the bar for a well-earned drink. I've asked all the players this. It's the first time we've run a LAN, so I think it's important that we're transparent and we ask about what was good, but also what was bad, if anything. So what was the best thing for you at this tournament, and what was the worst thing?
Well, the best thing is obviously the event was held in a hotel. I kind of get the CPL feeling back. You go into the room, you sleep, you wake up, you take the elevator, bing bong, and you're up in the event, right? So that's awesome. I think the setup was good as well. You did a nice job having the teams on, usually on different sides of the, so you don't always have to face them. Monitors were decent. I mean,
they could have been better.
Could have been better, but it's fine. You told them in advance so people could prepare for that. Computer was fine. CSGO is a new game. It's hard to find the right settings. That concerns all of us. It's hard to find, but everything setup-wise was good, really good. And delays, always going to happen in CS. Can't complain about that.
We're gonna work on it the next time. It was a bit of a shame that we're finishing so late, because it's eating into our drinking time. But anyway, look, great champions. It's great to finally talk to you. I've never done an interview with you, so thanks very much for doing that. I really appreciate it. And to all the people out there at cadred.org, do stay tuned to the website. We've still got a few more interviews to come as the games are wrapping up here from the AMD Sapphire CSGO Invitational in Prague.